So, there is a one question, question number 5, which you just refer to your questions. If the time displacement graph of a particle is parallel to the time axis, okay, then the velocity of the particle is. So, instead of this type of the graph, time displacement graph is parallel to the time axis. Okay. So, displacement versus time graph is parallel to the time axis. What is the conclusion that you can, that you will draw? In this particular case, the displacement is not changing. So, automatically we can say that body is at rest. Okay. So, displacement time graph will give us so, the velocity of the particle must be equal to 0 because there is no change in the position of the body. If the time is increasing, the displacement is still same. So, there is no change in the position of the body. Therefore, the velocity of the particle must be equal to 0. Okay? Now, these are the graphs of displacement versus time and distance versus time. Okay. Now the next graph, different graph that we are going to study, the next graph that will be under consideration is about the velocity versus time graph or speed versus time graph. These graphs are very important because from these graphs we can find out various quantities that are associated with the motion of the body. Okay. Suppose that you plot a graph of speed versus time now. We have already plotted the graph of distance versus time. Now I am going to plot a graph of speed versus time. Okay? Speed versus time. Okay? Now, let us assume that the graph is parallel to the time axis. Okay? What is the conclusion that can be drawn from this particular graph? The conclusion that we can draw is speed is suppose 4 meter per second. Okay, this value is 4 meter per second. After 1 second, it is 4 meter per second. After 2 seconds, it is again 4 meter per second. After 3 seconds, again it is 4 meter per second. So, the speed of the particle is not changing. Okay, so automatically, in this particular case, we can say that the speed is uniform. There is no change in its value. Okay? Now, if you plot a graph of, instead of speed, if you plot a graph of velocity versus time, and suppose that it is parallel to the time axis, okay? Then what is the conclusion that we can draw? Here, the velocity is not changing. So, automatically the conclusion is body is moving with uniform velocity. Okay, body is moving with uniform velocity. It is not accelerated. It is moving with a constant speed, we can say. If it is moving along the same straight line, then we will get a nature of the graph of velocity versus time, which is parallel to the time axis. Okay, now suppose you draw a graph of velocity versus time which is of this nature. Okay, so velocity versus time. This is a straight line again, see. Okay, now in this particular case, your velocity is not uniform. Of course, it is an accelerated motion because the velocity is increasing. After 1 second, it was 4 meter per second, say. After second, you are accelerating your car, for example. In the second, the speed becomes 8 meter per second. In the third, it becomes 12 meter per second. Okay? So, your speed is increasing. Okay, 12 meter per second. So, in this particular case, if it is moving along a straight line, then it is said to be having an acceleration. You are accelerating the car, your velocity is increasing. So we say that in this particular case, the velocity is increasing, and we can find out the slope of this particular graph. Slope of this particular graph will give us another quantity, which is very important one. Slope of this particular graph will give me the change in the slope. I already explained how to calculate. You have to take two different points. You have to calculate y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So slope will be nothing but equal to 12 minus 8, suppose third second and second that I am taking. So 12 minus 8 upon 3 minus 2. So slope is giving me another quantity, how my velocity changing with respect to time. Okay. Now the change in velocity with respect to time is called a quantity which is called as the acceleration. So acceleration is nothing but change in velocity. Change in velocity upon time. Okay. So slope will be equal to 4 upon 1, 4 meter per second upon second. So automatically it will be 4 meter per second square. So the acceleration is measured in terms of meter per second square or centimeter per second square. In SI system, the unit is meter per second square. So the first question that they have asked, unit of acceleration is change in velocity. Acceleration is change in velocity upon time. That is nothing but equal to meter per second upon second. So the units are meter per second square. Okay. So in this particular case, the velocity is increasing uniformly because the graph is a straight line. So velocity is increasing uniformly. So this will be a uniform motion which is under consideration. You are accelerating it with uniform acceleration of 4 meter per second square. Okay. But then instead of that, if you get a graph of velocity versus time, something like this. Okay, velocity versus time. Okay. The nature of the graph is velocity like this. So what is the conclusion that we can draw in this particular case? Here the velocity is not, here the velocity is increasing uniformly, while here the velocity is not increasing uniformly. Initial the increase in the velocity was less, but then after each second the velocity is increasing tremendously. So automatically, if the nature of the graph of velocity versus time is a curve, then the conclusion that we can draw is that velocity is not increasing uniformly. Okay. Now instead of, so here the velocity is increasing. Okay. Now if you get a graph of velocity versus time, which is of nature something like this. Okay. So what is the conclusion that we can draw from this particular graph? Okay. Initially your velocity is increasing at a faster rate, while as the time passes, the increase in the velocity becomes less and less. So here we can say that the velocity is, initially it is increasing, but finally it is decreasing and it will reach to the maximum value. Or we can say if the graph becomes parallel to the time axis, then we can say that velocity reaches the saturation value, it reaches the maximum value and it is not changing now. Okay. So in this, so these are the different graphs that we have discussed. Velocity versus time graph, if it is a straight line, then it is uniform velocity with which you are increasing your speed. While in the second graph, velocity versus time graph, it is a curve, then here the velocity is increasing like this. Here velocity versus time graph is something like that, then the velocity is decreasing and it is reaching to the maximum value. Okay. Now you can just refer to question number 10. In figure 1.7, the velocity of the body at A is, okay, so they have So we can refer to this particular question number 10. Okay, we can just discuss displacement versus time. We can solve this question now. Okay, OAB. Okay, now we want to discuss this question. Okay, the velocity of the body at A is. Now this type of the graph you will obtain if you just throw a ball in upward direction. Okay, now in this particular case what will happen? If we have thrown ball with certain velocity, therefore its velocity is maximum initially. It will go on decreasing. I have already explained that if the nature of the graph is something like that, then the velocity is decreasing. Okay, so up to the point A, it has reached to the saturation value. Okay, so the velocity of the body at A is 0, unity, maximum, infinite. Okay, now when you will now what will happen in this particular case, the change in the displacement. Okay, now when the body is thrown vertically upward, then its velocity will go on decreasing and it will reach to a certain point. At that particular point it will remain stationary, or we can say that it is remains for a fraction of second. It will remain over there and it will travel its downward journey. Okay, so automatically during that particular time there is no change in the displacement of the body. It reaches to the maximum value and it reaches to the value which is equal to 0. So here you are started with some initial velocity, the velocity goes on decreasing and finally it reaches to the 0 value when you are throwing some body upward. And when it is coming down, then again the velocity of the body goes on increasing. Okay, so whenever it reaches to the lowest point, then the velocity becomes maximum again. So in this particular case, in the above equation, the velocity increases between O to A. Okay, is it increasing? No, it is decreasing. We have started with some initial value, then increases between A and B. So it is increasing between A and B, decreasing between A and B, okay, and it's 0 throughout. Okay, so the correct answer is of course increasing between A and B. Okay, so displacement versus time graph and the corresponding velocities that you will get if the body is thrown vertically upward is shown in question number 10, in which the graph is like this. From O to A, it will go on decreasing and finally it becomes 0 for a fraction of the second, and then when you will, then the body will start coming back and it will reach to you in your hand at the point B, so that the displacement becomes equal to 0 after some time. Okay, so automatically but from O to B the velocity goes on increasing. Okay, then so we have discussed various quantities. Such as distance, which is equal to actual length of the path that is taken by the particle. Secondly, we have discussed about displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance between initial position and final position along with direction. Then we have discussed about speed. Speed is nothing but distance upon time, or the rate of displacement with respect to time will be called as a velocity. So speed and velocity, speed is a scalar quantity, velocity is a vector quantity. And if you want to have change in the velocity, then you must have a quantity which is called as the acceleration. which is equal to change in velocity upon time, and the units are meter per second square. Now, I want to discuss another type of the motion, which is a uniform circular motion. Okay? Now, in a uniform circular motion, the body is going to move along a circumference of a circle. Okay? What do you mean by circular motion? A body is going to move along the circumference of a circle. Okay? Now, we want to describe uniform circular motion. Okay? Uniform circular motion is a motion of a body along a circumference of a circle with a constant speed. I am using the word speed and not velocity. Okay? So, if the body is moving along the circumference of a circle with constant speed, then we say that the body is moving with a uniform circular motion. Okay? Why I am describing like this, uniform circular motion? Why I am not using the term velocity? Okay? Because when the particle is moving along the circumference of a circle, then the velocity of the particle is always along the tangent drawn to the circle from the position of the particle. Okay? So, suppose the particle is at this particular point, okay? Then the velocity will be represented, just draw the tangent to this particular circle and you will get the direction of the velocity. If it is at this particular point, then the direction of the velocity will be like this. If the particle reaches at this particular point, then the direction of the velocity is like this. Although the magnitude of the velocity can remain constant, okay? But the velocity is a vector quantity and it requires magnitude as well as direction, and the direction of the particle is changing continuously when it is moving along a circular motion. So here we will say that the velocity is changing continuously, and we will say that since the velocity is changing continuously, it is an accelerated motion. Okay? So, circular motion is an accelerated motion because the velocity of the body, which is along the tangent drawn to the circle from the position of the particle in the direction of the motion, it is changing continuously. Therefore, we can say that it is an accelerated motion. Okay? While the magnitude of the velocity can remain same, therefore what we can say that the speed can remain same, because magnitude of the velocity is called as the speed. For example, we can say that the fan in the room is moving with a constant speed, not with a constant velocity, because in case of uniform circular motion, speed can remain constant, not velocity. Okay, so uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion, because although the magnitude of the velocity is remaining change, direction of the velocity is continuously changing. So here we say that it is an accelerated motion. Okay? Now, for example, now let us calculate one more example that I will take. Suppose that there is an athlete who is moving along a 400 meter path, circular path. Okay? Circular track is over there, and the length of the track is 400 meter. Okay? He is covering this track in say 20 seconds. Okay? Time required to complete one revolution is 20 seconds. Okay? Now, what is his displacement after say 50 seconds? Okay? So, after 20 seconds, he will cover 400 meter. After next 20 seconds, he will cover 400 meter. And another 400 meters, that is 800 meter. And after 10 seconds, that is additional 10 seconds, he will reach diagonally opposite over here. Okay, so if he starts from this point A, then he will reach to the point B. Okay, which is along the diameter of the circle. Okay? Now, here, what is the distance that he has traveled? Distance traveled is equal to 1000 meters. Okay? Or if they have just given the radius, then 2 pi r plus 2 pi r plus pi r. Okay? Half of that. So that will be equal to 5 pi r. But then, what is the displacement of this particular boy? Now, while measuring the displacement, you must measure the shortest distance between initial position and final position. So, after 50 seconds, he has reached to the point B. The shortest distance between A and B is nothing but the diameter of the circle. Okay? So, AB will be the displacement of that particular boy, okay, during this interval of the time. So, displacement is equal to AB, or that is equal to R plus R. So, that is displacement is always equal to 2R, while the distance that he has covered is 5 pi R, or that is equal to 1000 meter. So, distance and displacement, they are totally different quantities. One is a scalar quantity, while second is a vector quantity. Okay? So, then I will just solve one more question. The rate of the question number 6, the rate of change of displacement with time is called as a displacement upon time is called as a velocity. So the answer is D. Then a train passes, the next question, a train passes over a 400 meter long bridge. If the speed of the train is 30 meter per second and train takes 20 seconds to cross the bridge, then the length of the train is, okay. Now when the train is passing, then in this particular case, speed of the train is equal to distance it is going to cover. So it will have to cover distance of the bridge. Okay? Distance of bridge plus distance between the engine and last bogie. Okay? So that will give me the length of the train. Because then only we will say, when the whole train passes over the bridge, then we will say that the train has passed the bridge. So automatically, the total distance that it has to travel is equal to distance of the bridge plus length of the train upon time required for this. Okay, the speed is given, and speed is given as equal to 30 meter per second. Distance of the bridge is 400 plus length we want to calculate upon time required is 20. So automatically 600 is equal to 400 plus L. Therefore L is equal to 600 minus 400, that is equal to 200 meter. Okay? So that is about the different questions that we have asked in this particular point. Okay. Now, we have already plotted the graph of displacement versus time, or distance versus time, and corresponding speed versus time, and velocity versus time. I will just complete that particular point and then I will stop. Okay. Okay. Suppose that this is the graph of velocity versus time. Suppose that it is a straight line. What is the conclusion that we have drawn? We have drawn that in this particular case, there is no change in the velocity, or body is moving with uniform velocity. Okay. Now, it is not an accelerated motion. Okay? Now, if you calculate area under the curve, okay, this is very important point that I am discussing. Area under the curve, okay. So, O, A, B, C. This is up to this particular point, okay. So, what is the area under the curve is representing? Area under the curve is representing, area is nothing but equal to, area is nothing but equal to length multiplied by breadth, okay. So, length is nothing but equal to OA, breadth is nothing but equal to OB. OA is representing the velocity, so area is representing, OA is representing the velocity, while OB is representing the time, okay, required for that. Okay, so velocity into time. Now we know that velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Displacement upon time. Okay, so that is, so velocity into time is nothing but the displacement. Okay, so what is the area under the graph of velocity versus time representing? It is representing nothing but the displacement of the body. Okay, so displacement of the body is represented by velocity, area under the curve of velocity versus time graph. Instead of velocity, if it is speed versus time, then the area under the curve, instead of displacement, we will get a quantity which is called as a distance, because speed is equal to distance upon time. Okay, so speed will be represented by OA, time will be represented by OB. So OA into OB will give me the value of speed multiplied by time, and speed multiplied by time represent a quantity which is called as a distance. So distance covered by the body during this particular interval of the time, when the speed of the body is uniform, is represented by area under the curve, which is equal to OA into OB. Okay, so area under the curve represent either displacement or distance. If you plot the graph of velocity versus time, then area under the curve will represent displacement. If you plot a graph of speed versus time, then you will get distance that is covered by the body during this interval of the time. So let us stop at this particular point, and we will discuss different examples on the graphs that we have studied next time. Okay, thank you.